Welcome to another episode of Millennial Investing Explained. Here's today's question. Now, shifting gears to another strategy called momentum investing. I know it's become an aspect of your portfolio over the last few years, Preston. Can you talk us through what momentum investing is and why you've come to like it?
So I have to give credit to a couple different people for this strategy because I was, you know, I thought this was not something that was worth my time when I first started out investing. I had a real strong bias to value investing, which is Warren Buffett's style of investing. But I had some people that have influenced my thinking, and some of those people are James O'Shaughnessy. In my opinion, one of the greatest quant investors that are out there and really kind of put a fire into this entire field of quant investing. And one of the aspects that he talks about is mixing value investing with momentum investing. Now, you had two people, Tobias Carlyle and also Wes Gray, piggybacked on a lot of what James O'Shaughnessy did as far as his research. And they also further confirmed that when you mix a momentum strategy and a value strategy, that you can produce better results. And this is all based on back testing, which doesn't mean that the future results will be the same, but it's very convincing when you look at what they're doing. Here's momentum investing. When a company is doing well, call it Amazon, the company continues to accelerate in price because the market continues to pile into it. It now gives them more capital in order to employ, which allows them to further produce better results and so on and so forth. And it drives itself. The success drives upon itself.
I know Preston just mentioned quite a few people, and it might be difficult to remember them all if you're listening to this while you're driving or working out or just busy doing something else. So I'll be sure to put links to all of those people in the show notes so that you can go back and check them out later, which I would highly recommend that you do. All of the people that he just recommended are highly successful investors. And those are the types of people that you want to emulate. Like we talked about at the beginning of the show, those are the types of investors that you want to go research and study and try to mimic your investing strategy after. Now, talking about momentum more specifically, it almost sounds like you're timing the market. Intuitively, it makes sense. I understand what you're doing, but it almost sounds to me like you're timing the market. And if you're waiting for certain indicators, isn't it too late for you and you kind of already missed that opportunity?
Well, yeah, I think that for anybody who thinks they can absolutely nail the top of a market and you're starting your journey, you're going to have some painful experiences ahead of you. I look at it as a stop loss strategy. So if I'm locking in gains and I'm making money and I want to protect my downside risk, momentum for me is a great way to protect my downside risk by understanding what the normal operating volatility is. And if I'm not participating in a company that has insanely high volatility, let's say the annual volatility range is 8%, I might lose 8-10% from the top of whatever it hit. And I'm fine with that because I'm hopefully entering the position using very similar principles and buying them not just based on momentum, but also value indicators. And so I'm able to buy them at a severe discount and I buy them after the momentum changes to the upside and then I hold on to them for a while. So if I lose a little bit on the top, I'm fine with that. What I think is a really, really, really important math equation for people to understand is a very simple but highly misunderstood math equation. And it goes something like this. If you have a stock that rose to $100 and it now drops 50%. You now have to get 100% return to get back to where you were. That's a 50% loss to 100% gain. So now, if you study financial markets and you realize that a business cycle usually lasts 7 to 8 years, and it typically has a 50% contraction at that point before it goes on another big giant growth spurt, that means that if you don't protect your wins and you don't protect your principal and you participate in the whole downturn and you keep locked and loaded into that downturn and you have a 50% loss, what you're really kind of losing there is the long time that it's going to take to get back and gain 100% return to get you back to the principal that you were at. So Buffett has a saying. He says, rule number one is don't lose money. Rule number two is refer back to rule number one. And what he's really getting at with that is this math equation that I'm saying is really important is that If you lose 50%, it takes 100% return to get it back. And you got to understand that if you're participating in financial markets. Do not lose money. You got to protect your principal. You got to be very defensive in the way that you invest.
Now, with all that being said, do you think this is a good strategy for millennial investors to implement?
Well, let me put it this way. I don't do momentum investing on its own, period. I don't put on a position strictly based on momentum. I put on a position that starts with value investing principles, which involves reading a 10K or 10Q and kind of determining what the value of something is. And we can talk about what that looks like and what that is. And then whenever I determine that I think that something is being penalized in the market that has value that I think is giving me a return higher than what like the S&P 500 index could give me, then I'm looking at the momentum indicators to determine whether the pain is over, because typically when you're finding great buys, it's because they've been penalized on their market price and the market has sold them off. These companies or financial assets have been sold off in a major way. And so then they become a value because everyone's penalized the price so much, which pushes the yield higher. And so what I'm doing is I'm trying to find those companies, those fixed income securities, whatever it is that I think has been severely penalized. But then I'm looking for the statistical change in the momentum. So I augment the momentum with a value-based approach in order to not catch the falling knife, which is a term that's used in value investing, and that I can kind of, I hate to use the word time, but I think I can get my timing right a little bit better whenever I augment my value investing approach with momentum investing.
For all the reasons you've mentioned and that we've talked about, I've begun implementing a momentum aspect into my personal investing as well. But just like you said, it's not momentum on its own. It's paired with value investing or at least another strategy.
That's all for this episode of Millennial Investing Explained. Be sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, or subscribe to our YouTube channel to get even more free content.